Welcome back. You're with us here on Trading Hour. The market's down about 30 points, not very much by way of change. 1,224 stocks are lower, 556 stocks are higher. So that's now 2-1 in favor of declines on the NSE. Sachin Shah from MK Investment Managers is now joining us to talk about what he makes of the market right now. Sachin, thanks very much. Good to have you here. Is this rally, in your opinion, likely to stretch quite a bit more, Sachin? And if so, how should one position oneself?
Hi, Prashant. Thank you for having me. So, Prashant, that's a very important question. I think it's at the top of everybody's mind. To answer it very straight without dodging all around. If you ask me that in the very near to medium, I mean, say very near term, yes, of course, we've had a very, very sharp rally. We've had a very sharp run up. So if you see from the month of April, which is after the crash in the month of March, where we saw a crash of almost 30%. From April till now, I think the large cap indices are up more than 50%. The mid cap and the small caps are up about 65 to 75%. So that's a very good, sharp run up. And from that perspective, yes, there could be some cool off in the overall rally. There could be some profit booking with some investors and all of that could happen. And of course, FIIs have also been buying very, very heavily in the last 2 months, because if you see just the month of October and November, they have bought nearly worth $12 billion plus, and of course, additional some more in December. But the important thing is that that's more about the near-term thing. That we could see some kind of pull-off. But when I look at the overall ground-level reality, the way things have bounced back, I think let's accept that most of us were not expecting the kind of the demand revival. We did not anticipate it to be so much sharp and even so much quicker. Also, the most important thing is that the COVID has played a role of a catalyst with a lot of, I would say, the entire Indian corporates. The kind of the cost structures, efficiency that we have seen in the last 6 months is amazing. And a lot of that will stay in the next few quarters also. So if I think about the next 12 to 18 months, I think finally we are in for a good earnings growth from many, many companies across the sectors. And from that perspective, I think we will see this rally being much broad-based, much stronger over a period of next 12 to 18 months. And we have to also remember one thing more, Prashant, that actually speaking, we are just recovering what we had lost. Because if you see on a calendar year basis, the indices are up about 8-9%, not more, on the large cap. The mid caps and small caps may be up 15-20%, but we have to again remember that calendar year 2018 and 2019, the mid caps and small caps were down very significantly. So actually speaking, we are just recovering a large part of our losses or little bit of gains.
Sachin, morning. Where do you stand on the PSU stocks? They're making a comeback. You know, they've been laggards for the last many years. Would you bet on them? Is something changing in the environment for them? And if yes, which ones?
Frankly, for all the last 5 to 7 years, we have completely avoided investing in the PSU stocks. And of course, the last 5 to 7 years, we have seen humongous amount of price destruction or the wealth destruction that has happened with the PSU companies. And obviously, everything is good at a price and bad at a price. And probably at a price that where they are today, there is very, very deep value. So as a trade, maybe there is some profit to be made. But if I think about on a secular way, if I have to take a 3 to 5 year view, whether do I see their earnings growing significantly? Do I see a paradigm shift in terms of their operations? I'm not very sure at this point in time, because one of the key reasons what we have seen is that the entrepreneurial spirit is what drives the business growth, business earnings, and eventually the wealth creation for the shareholders or all the stakeholders actually. Some of that has been significantly lacking across most of the PSU companies.
Many have though been pointing out, Sachin, that the government is a lot, seems like it's walking the talk, right? And the talk itself has sort of been quite positive. For example, the disinvestment secretary at a CII event said that the MOUs which are going to be signed between public sector companies and the government will have improvement in market capitalization type clauses. PSU companies will need to give multiple dividends through the year. the regular off of a sales, you know, that will no longer be the case. It'll be more selective and they'll be better spaced out. These are all things which we are hearing from the government. Now, does that make any difference as far as investment thesis goes? I get your point that you want to look at not just short-term gains, but slightly more structural stories. But is this getting a little better at the margin?
Well, Prashant, definitely it is something that we are, I would say, it is on our radar. And we will not be ignoring it. That's the way I would like to look at it. But it, at this point in time, it will be in a wait and watch mode.
Sachin, we'll leave it at that. Thanks so much for joining in. On that note, it's time for a very short break. But up next, we will discuss the